You will have seen Notch live coding Minecraft. Minecraft is coded in Java, so it's not surprising that this is possible. For a virtual world coded in Python or Lua or JavaScript, it would be even less surprising. But what if the language were statically compiled? If you look at MineTest, which is coded in C++, it uses Lua for scripting, precisely for this reason, because it can't use C++ for live coding. Now, the tracer is coded in Oberon, to be precise, Active Oberon, and it's very much statically compiled. Now, it's not possible in Oberon to free a module which is referred to by other modules in memory. That is, running code cannot be modified. Yet, a shackled mother bears a free child, as the saying goes, and one can load new code, as I will show you. So, what is desired is that I can be in the world, and I can draw. Right now I'm drawing holes, or blank voxels, that's why holes are opening up. I'm going to start drawing, after a couple more empty boxes, I'm going to start drawing with a sphere. Okay, so this is sphere. Now, that's my current cursor, the thing that I'm drawing with, and there's a keyboard command, which is B, but it doesn't, it's arbitrary. There's a keyboard command, and in order to show this better, I'm going to decrease the size of the tracer window so that you can see the development window which the tracer is being run from, which is an Active Oberon window. Alright? And when I hit key B, I get popping up in my development environment the code that is associated with that voxel, that draws that voxel. I make one character change to the name of the file, and to the name of the module, and to the command at the end of the module. Make some slight change to the code, save, compile, go down, and I bring up the kernel log so you can see the result of what I'm going to do next. So, I res, and res that code that I just compiled. And look, there, looks quite different. We'll repeat this again. Again, so now I'm drawing that. And I sum the code. Ooh, here's the code window. And I make an arbitrary change to the name, making sure that the name of the module and the name of the file match. Make some slight change to the code, which is statically compiled, so it's very fast. Of course, it doesn't matter in the case of this code, but you could change shading code too, that the ray tracer goes through. Alright. And you get that. Voila.